Okay, just talking about the commission on appointments and you not being confirmed, there were a couple of issues that were raised about that that could have affected your appointment. But you were given a chance to defend yourself. Do you think you were able to clarify those issues, even if they did not confirm you, sir?
Yes, sir. My lawyers have made an extensive research after the second bypass. And after doing so, they even talked to the Commission of Elections offices because yung sinasabi na moral turpitude actually it only applies to dun sa mga political appointees. But then again, we still sought the opinion of some legal minds, retired justices of the Supreme Court, and so we have answers already. When it comes to citizenship, I have already surrendered my citizenship, Ron. So the U.S. Embassy. So there's nothing really questioned. So if the higher ups would decide to give me another shot or try, then I guess my lawyers can answer all these questions now, Ron, and we're prepared. But wherever, like a good soldier, Ron, I am kung saan ilalagay tayo ni Pangulo and best serve the country, then we'll just follow, Ron.
Just one more thing about your appointment. Do you think politics was involved in you being bypassed, lawmakers getting back at you for your criticism of their work when you were still a broadcaster, or even getting back at your brother for banging heads with other lawmakers?
Ron, there's a lot of factors, sir, that is involved. Pero I don't want to make any more comments regarding that matter. Pero I believe the commission and appointments were just doing their job. Yung nga lang, sir, medyo we were not ready that time to answer all those yung particularly the moral turpitude, but now we're ready, and now we have opinions of legal minds. Ilan sa kanila are former Supreme Court justices, and we can answer those allegations now, Saron.
Okay, you just said that you'll wait for the president, where he'll put you in what position. If it's not going to be a secretary post or a cabinet post, and he said that it's not, you're not going to be a presidential advisor. If you were asked, what would be your preference? In what capacity would you like to serve under this administration, given your strengths and your following and your experience as a broadcaster?
Social services, siguro, Sir Ron. That's where really, right now, when I was still with ABS-CBN, we had public service programs that were given to me. I think more in public service, Sir Ron. Other than that, siguro, I will just tell the president that I can help him in any other way. Pero I think he also mentioned last night that he's eyeing somewhere like my social services aspect, the position. So we'll see, Sir Ron. Sabi ko nga, I'll just follow. He's the boss, and he used to be my boss. So I will see. And kung makakatulong, why not?
Yes, Sir Erwin Tulfo, formerly of the DSWD, will wait for the announcement of a new position. Thank you very much, Erwin.
Thank you, Sir Ron. Good evening.